Hi friends, this is Pooja. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing a vlog, and for some time, some days I'm going to do just vlogs from home. My daily day-to-day work and day-to-day life vlogs. I will not be able to post it every day, but I'll try to post every alternate days. And yes, I will keep posting my recipe shots for you all. And as I said, COVID cases are rising and the second strain is very strong, guys. So please stay safe and stay at home. Go out only when it is necessary. Even I have decided not to go out. I will not be able to give you any further recommendations, food recommendations or shopping recommendations for some time because I am not taking any invites or any other work as of now. I'm going to stay safe at home. And which is why I've decided to bring you many more vlogs from home. I will try to do as much as possible. So let's get started with today's vlog. It is about an ice cream maker machine that I have received from KitchenF. And this is not a part of my YouTube promotion at all. Please let me make this very clear. This is not a promotional video, friends. This is just an unboxing and my experience with the machine. I received this ice cream maker from KitchenF as part of my Instagram promotion, and in fact it was not even a promotion. They gifted me this, and I have just decided to do a YouTube video, an unboxing and my experience with the ice cream maker. So yeah, let's get started. So yes friends, this is the ice cream maker that I was talking about. So without wasting any time, let's get started. They've given me a recipe and guidebook, which is much needed because I know nothing about it. How does it work and what are the functionalities? So this is going to help me a lot. So this is it. It's a small one, but sufficient enough to make ice cream for a family of four, I guess. So yeah, this is how we open it. Wait, I don't even know its functionality yet. Okay, so we need to press it from here. See, if you can see, we need to press this from here and open, and this is how it gets locked. So if I try to pull it up, it's not coming. I need to press this and pull it up. So this is the paddle. This is removable, and this is the tub, and this is where all the magic happens, and it is removable, and I think you can further remove this, and this I think has to be refrigerated. So I just read this instruction. It says that this is the inner bowl, and it has water inside. If I shake, I can hear it. So it says we need to refrigerate this. It says freeze the inner bowl beforehand for 12 to 18 hours in a double door or above refrigerator freezer, not single door fridge. Shake the bowl well to check if it's frozen completely. That means before I use it, I need to freeze it for at least 12 to 18 hours, and before taking it out, I need to shake it. Now I can hear the water inside, but after it's freeze, I won't be able to hear this. So which means it is ready to use. So let me do that first. Let me wash this completely and then let me freeze it. Yeah, I'm keeping it in the freezer. Inner bowl is freezing up. I'm going to prepare the ice cream mixture. So here I have milk, and to this I'm adding in the corn flour. I will give the exact ingredients and the measurements in the description box. You may check. And to this I'm also adding in sugar. I feel this is easier for me to mix than adding it in the milk. So yeah, I'm blending this now. So now this is ready without any lumps in it, and the sugar has dissolved completely. Now we are going to heat milk in a pan and then add this slowly, and this is going to act as a thickening agent. Corn flour is going to act as a thickening agent, and which is why we are using this. There are other options as per their recipe book, which says you may use GMS powder and CMC powder, but that is completely optional. I don't have them, so I'm not using. So to this I'm adding in milk, and we need to heat this up. We did not bring it to a boil, just heat it up. So here our milk is warm enough to add the slurry that we had prepared, that is the milk, corn flour and the sugar. Now we are going to stir this continuously to avoid formation of lumps. Our milk is now thick enough. You can see the consistency has changed because of corn flour, and as I said, that is the thickening agent. Now to this I'm going to add in my Amul cream. You may use any cream, I just have Amul, so I'm adding in that. So now we are going to mix and stir in the cream well till it all mixes up well, and then we are going to strain this to add in our vanilla essence or vanilla extract. Yes, we need to strain this, that is an important step. So I'm adding in the vanilla extract, or you may also use vanilla essence, and we need to mix this well. If you actually notice, there is a thin layer of cream that is forming, and we need to stir this and cover this with a cling film. If not a cling film, a wrap, a plastic wrap, or exactly sticking to this, so that we to avoid that thin layer of cream which is getting formed. This is how we need to cover it now. This is ready to get into our refrigerator or freezer. I'm going to keep it in the fridge. So yeah guys, now it's the time for me to remove this bowl from the freezer, and I think it's set. Here I have taken out this as well, and it's chilled enough, and I will remove this and pour in the batter. Pour in the ice cream into the ice cream maker, into the tub inside, which is chilled. So we will start this first as per the instruction. We need to start it, start the machine, and the paddle has to rotate, and then we need to start pouring in our ice cream. So yeah, I'm keeping this inside and I'm fixing it in. So I've reset the time because I wanted it exact 20 minutes. I'm going to pour this mixture slowly. So that's the process, as you can see. So this is the next morning, friends, and I'm so sorry I couldn't record the further process of the ice cream making. That's because my phone's battery had drained completely and it was too late in the night, so I couldn't wait as well. So which is why I'm recording this, I'm shooting this the next day, that is the next morning, when I had to click this picture for my Instagram post. So the taste of the ice cream was very good, but it wasn't very creamy, and that's only because I didn't use the GMS powder, and this time I've decided to use the powder and make it, and I will put it up on the shots.
So that's all for now, and I hope you like this video, and if you want more such videos, more such day-to-day vlogs, please give your comments and let me know. And so please do like, share and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram for all the latest updates. Thank you.